Good noon to all of our media friends and partners. On behalf of Vice President and Secretary Sara Z. Duterte, on Monday, I would like to announce that the Department of Education will formally open school year 2022 to 2023 on August 22, 2022, and will end on July 7, 2023. In accordance to DepEd Order Number 034, Series of 2022, issued last Monday. In the department order, we have also provided direction and guidance in the reopening of classes and the gradual introduction of 5 days in-person learning modality classes. We would like to note that there will be no inspections, tools, or any additional requirements to reopen schools and to implement 5 days in-person classes, which will be required except for the compliance with the usual pre-pandemic regulatory permits and licenses as required by law or ordinances. In our recognition of the current COVID-19 situation, we've also prescribed the options of 5 days in-person classes, blended learning modality, and or full distance learning until October 31, 2022 only. Public schools that were already implementing the 5 days in-person classes at the end of school year 2021 to 2022 shall continue to do the same at the beginning of the incoming school year. By November 2, 2022, we are instructing all public and private schools to transition to 5 days in-person classes. Meanwhile, we will conduct the regular enrollment from July 25 to August 22, and the Brigada Escuela and Oplan Balik Escuela on August 1 to 26 and August 15, respectively. For more details about the department order on the school calendar, please refer or you can go to the DepEd website for you to be able to see more details about what is in store for school year 2022 to 23 and the details of such order. Thank you very much. And again, good noon.
Good afternoon, Usec Epimaco Densing, and good afternoon to our media partners. This is Mr. Sen Perez from the Media Relations and Events Unit. For the interest of time, kindly allow us to read your advanced questions. First, we will be reading questions on the recently released DepEd Order Number 34, Series of 2022, or the school calendar and activities for the school year. And our first question will be coming from Ms. AC Nichols of CNN Philippines. And her question is, Section 17 of the Department Order on the School Calendar for 2022 to 2023 indicates that all schools must carry out 5 days in-person classes by November. Just to clarify, will this be mandatory and will we see a classroom setup similar to pre-pandemic days? Or will it still be voluntary, meaning parents or students may choose not to attend in-person classes? If mandatory, how will classroom congestion be avoided, particularly in public schools? And I suppose the second question is similar to the first, so allow me to read it, Usec. The second question goes, with the 5 days of in-person classes in all public and private schools by November 2, what measures will be implemented by DepEd to observe health protocols against the spread of COVID-19, especially on physical distancing, as some class sizes reach up to more than 50 learners?
As pronounced in the department order, signed and issued by the Vice President and Secretary Sara Duterte, by November 2, all public and private schools are now mandated to have face-to-face classes 5 times a week. However, the full transition to full operations will be done in transition. Initially, we will be starting with what we call staggered and clustered attendance of students on a daily basis, where the students will be attending 2 to 3 hours face-to-face classes and the rest of the day in their going back to their homes, and where they will be given what we call soft learning modules as part of the whole program. But again, however, this is in transition, and we expect that all schools eventually will have full operational capacity within the school premises. With respect to the question on congestion or possible congestions within the rooms, we have directed our regional directors to determine and to ensure there are social distancing within the classroom. I believe there are rooms, the rooms are dependent, the capacity of the rooms are really varies. There are rooms that has a 50 seat capacity, there are rooms that are 30s or 20s, And then we leave it to the determination of the regional directors just to ensure social distancing within the classroom.
For our third question, this will be coming from Mr. Bonds Magsumbol of Rappler. The question is, will the face-to-face mandatory for all or the students can opt out if they don't feel so?
No, this is mandatory. They're all required to go to school, and the mandate is really to eventually go face to face. And everybody who is enrolled should abide by the department order. And parents are also encouraged to ensure that their students go to school. Again, we're trying to do some education or learning recovery because in the past 2 years, because of the COVID-19, we have really not made into the face-to-face really had something to do with the COVID that we could not be able to do that for the last 2 years. So this is the right time for us to undertake the face-to-face. And based on the department order, the policy is regardless of the alert level status of the local government unit, everybody has to do to go into face-to-face by November 2.
Okay, thank you, Usec. And for our fourth question, this will be coming from Ms. Stephanie Sevilla of the Philippine News Agency. And her question is, this DepEd order shall apply regardless of the COVID-19 alert level that the Interagency Task Force for the Management of Emerging Infectious Diseases or the Department of Health or DOH may impose in areas where schools are situated. Can you clarify on this, po? How about schools located under areas of surge? For instance, IATF raises alert level 1 to alert level 3. Will the face-to-face classes resume? Also, what will be the protocol if an unvaccinated student tested positive?
Well, as mentioned a while ago, the general policy or the general policy of DepEd on this is regardless of the alert level, we will move or go on with the face-to-face classes. However, we will now leave it to the Interagency Task Force for Management of Emerging Infectious Diseases that if there is such a surge and the Department of Health would recommend eventually that we go that we cease to do the face-to-face classes, the surge, we will just follow the decision of the IATF. So this is, again, as I mentioned, this is something that we have to do right now. Moving forward for purposes of making sure that we go back to the usual learning process of the students, as at least in the level of K to 12 levels.
Okay, thank you, Usec. And for our fifth question, this will be coming from Ms. Joyce Balancha of ABS-CBN. And her question is, just interviewed Cocopea and they are asking DepEd na sana po maging open sila sa option to retain blended modalities as options since maraming parents are not comfortable sending their children to schools.
The Vice President has already responded to the letter of Cocopea. And in the response of Vice President and Secretary Sara Duterte, she mentioned that in the meantime, until the start of the classes until November 2, again, as mentioned, they have the option to go 5 days of in-person classes. The second option is for them to have blended learning modality, meaning they can go 3 days in-person classes and 2 days of distance learning. And eventually, or slowly moving themselves to 2 days in-person classes and 3 days distance learning. Then eventually, and another option is online distance learning or full distance learning. But again, those three options are applicable from the start of the classes until October 31, 2022. But again, by November 2, 2022, as per department order, they will have to do face-to-face classes. In other words, they will have that transition period to be able to ensure that the health safety protocols will be put in place before full face-to-face classes are made or implemented by November 2.
Okay, thank you, Usec. And for the sixth question, this will be coming from Mr. Mark Makalalad of DZBB. And the question is, Alliance of Concerned Teachers said that urgent requisites should be met for a safe 100% face-to-face classes. Kasama rito ang double school maintenance and operating budget, employment of additional teachers to be able to implement the ideal class size of maximum of 35 students, and employment of nurses and utility personnel for every school. Alin sa mga ito ang matutugunan ng DepEd? Paano matitiyak na ligtas ang face-to-face classes sa November?
Well, una sa lahat, magpapalabas tayo ng karagdagang budget, no, na inaprubahan ng DBM for 2022. Magkakaroon ng karagdagang budget na ibababa po sa ating mga region para po madagdagan yung mga pangangailangan ng ating mga eskwelahan para po masigurado ang maayos na pagpapalakad ng ating mga eskwelahan kahit meron pa po tayong pandemic. So binibigay na po natin sa ating mga regional directors kung paano nila gagamitin itong karagdagang budget sa ating mga eskwelahan. At kasama na rin po ang mga sosyo na yan na binanggit ng ACT. At again, ito po yung nakadepende sa ating regional director kung yun po ang mga pangangailangan ng ating mga eskwelahan sa pagpapatakbo ng ating mga paaralan ngayong panahon ng pandemya pa.
Okay, from Ms. Claudette Siriaco, and her question is, okay, now we will be proceeding to questions related to DepEd's budget review. And for the seventh question, it will be coming from Mr. Neil Alcobert of Daily Tribune. And his question is, how much is the proposed budget for school year 2022 to 2023? Which program of the department has the biggest chunk of the budget?
Well, hinihingi po natin for 2023 is 800 billion, no? So, pero ito po ay pag-uusapan pa together with DBM. Hopefully, makuha natin yung buong budget. Gusto natin sabihin sana na gusto natin sundin ng ang UNESCO pananaw ng UNESCO na dapat at least 15% ng pambansang budget ay inilalaan sa edukasyon or 4 to 6% spending based on the country's gross domestic product. So itong gusto nating pananaw, pero ang malaking portion pa rin ng ating budget ay mabigyan ng tamang kompensasyon yung ating mga guro. So again, the bulk of the budget is really still on spending for our teachers.
Okay, thank you, Usec. And for our eighth question, this will be coming from Mr. Janvic Matei of the Philippine Star. And his question is, regarding budget review, what will be the priorities of the DepEd under VP Sara in terms of the present budget and the proposal for next year?
The VP Sara or Secretary Sara Duterte mentioned, and it's very clear to her, that the major investment should be ensuring that our learners improve in their standards. Quality education is key. And part of this is really also to improve the teaching standards or investing in the training and upgrading the standards of our teaching personnel, specifically our teachers. So these are the two major investment that the DepEd will do for the next 6 years. And hopefully we improve the quality of our education, accessibility to everybody, and of course resiliency to ensure the strong educational standards. And of course we want to make sure that we have quality students who will graduate from our basic education.
Okay, for our last question, Usec Densing, meron din po tayong question dito about our official statement which was released earlier. Here po yung question ni Ms. Jane Bautista of Inquirer. How is DepEd planning to hold the perpetrators accountable in the alleged sexual abuse cases at the Philippine High School for the Arts? What reforms will be implemented to ensure that such abuses will not take place in educational institutions, not only in PHSA, but in other schools as well?
Well, with regard to the PHSA issue, Vice President Sara Duterte immediately wrote the NBI and requested them to do a thorough and comprehensive investigation of what had happened or the alleged happenings of sexual abuse and physical abuse at the PHSA. We've already also dispatched our child protection unit and child rights education desk to also look into the situation and to verify whether or not or how true the allegations are. And more importantly, the school itself, no, the PHSA has already made their own moves to ensure or to investigate, ensure that such incident, if that really had happened, shall not be repeated again. And all our regional directors have been made aware of this, and most probably they will be issuing certain directives down the line to ensure that such happening will not happen in the schools where they are governing within the region.
Usec, I understand that you kept on mentioning po mandatory ng face-to-face classes sa lahat ng schools, mapang private or public, by November 2. Pero po, yung group of private schools, even yung Kokopea, were actually opposing po itong mandato na to, even beyond November 2, kasi napaghandaan na po nila ay hybrid, no, with the parents, na hindi sila full face-to-face classes po for the school year. Ano po mensahe niyo po sa mga schools and the, lalo na sa parents po na may mga agam-agam when it comes to full face-to-face po?
Well, right now, again, as I've mentioned, Vice President Sara has already responded to their query on whether or not they can continue with the hybrid learning modules. But again, the directive and the policy right now is to, again, go back to full face-to-face. I believe from today until October 31, they will have enough time to be able to prepare their health protocols and school or classroom infrastructure requirements to ensure that there's safety and protection of the students during the whole time that the face-to-face will now be implemented starting November 2. I believe we go on from there. The department order on school calendars and activities has been issued. We'll see if we can continue with the dialogue and communication with COCAPEA. This is something that we'll just have to engage in the next few months. But in the meantime, the policy has been set. The school calendars and activities have been issued. So we'll just follow it and implement it in the meantime. But we will make sure that there is continuous communication and engagement with our partners or school partners from the private sector.
Last na lang, sir, kasi meron din po silang raised na concerns about yung problem na po sa transportation and yung mga magulang na hindi pa rin pumapayag pagdating sa bakunahan po. Lalo na yung
sa mga siguro, kapatang. Ganitong gawin na lang natin. Sa Biyernes po, meron kaming pagpupulong sa iba't ibang ahensya ng gobyerno na pinamumunuan po o pinamusimulan po ng Department of Transportation, nandiyan po ang DALG at iba pang ahensya at kasama rin po kami. Sa Friday, we will be discussing protocols for the transport of students, especially still under a public health emergency. Siguro after that meeting, baka meron tayong mas malinaw na protocol sa transportation sa ating mga estudyante.
Usec, this is Ian Cruz of GMA News. Usec, nabanggit dun sa DO no, na regardless kung anong level ng IATF na ipapatupad na alert level, ano, I'm sorry, kanina kasi sinasagot mo to pero nawawala-wala tayo dun sa atin ng video. Pero Usec, paano kung sabi nga tumaas masyado yung alert level, naging alert level 3 and yung magulang ayaw nang papasukin yung bata, pwede po ba yun?
Basta ang general rule natin, regardless of the alert level, tuloy ang face-to-face. However, DepEd will give in and follow if the IATF, Management of Emerging Infectious Diseases, would decide that a certain local government unit will lock down or would recommend or approve that certain classes in a specific region or local government unit would we'd go back to this distance learning. So tingnan po natin yan on a case-to-case basis. Antayin lang po natin yan. Manggagaling po yung guidance sa IATF MEID kung kailangan ma-suspend ang face-to-face classes sa isang lugar. But again, we will go back to the general rule na face-to-face po muna tayo.
Usec, I'm sorry guys, last na. Ang Teachers Dignity Coalition, sabi nila okay naman daw magbukas tayo ng August 22, pero ang inaalala nila, kailangan din daw po ng sapat na pahinga ng mga guro at yung kahilingan daw po nila na makadialogo si Vice President Sara Duterte po.
Tama po, yung mga issue na yan, naparating na kay Vice President Sara, at nabanggit niya na magsiguro mag-schedule isang araw para magkaroon ng pag-uusap sa mga leader ng ating mga teachers para ma-confirm natin ito at anong pwedeng posibleng gawin para masigurado na ang focus lang ng ating mga guro ay magturo. Malinaw yun sa aming mga pagpupulong ni BP Sara, ang focus lang ng teacher ay magturo at masiguradong matuto ang mga bata.